Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. This is Asad Yaqub from Lahore, Pakistan, and I welcome you to my reading video. Okay? That's what I say in my videos. Anyways, we are going to start one reading test, and this is academic reading test, so you have to be like, you know, this. Okay? Two things. One thing is I say, let's go to fight, and the enemy is going to be a mouse. We are going to fight, an enemy is a mouse. And you'll be just like, okay, mouse, ordinary mouse. I'm not even afraid of mice and their small mice and all that. And if I say, let's go, and we are going to fight with lion, you'll be, acha, okay, I'm more alert and all that, right? So now we are going to fight with lion, not mouse, right? So you got to be active, alert, and I will give you time at the end of each section, at the end of every question type, so that you could discuss with your class fellows, right? Please make sure the person sitting next to you is also participating actively. If anyone is not writing, not searching, not doing anything, you have the right to tell him that please go on and do it. And if he or she doesn't listen to you, then you can tell me, sir, ye kuch nahi likh raha. Or sir, ye kuch nahi likh rahi, and all that. You should tell me. I don't want the, you know, in Punjabi we say donvatta. No, no, no. Pata nahi. I don't want any donvatta here, okay? I want active students here. Yeah, because you know, you are my responsibility. I was thinking a lot the way you were going back and all that. I discussed today, afternoon I was discussing with my wife that one student came all the way from there and then she had to go back. So I truly appreciate you and I'm thankful to you that you saw me, trusted me, and now you are here. So inshallah, I'll not break your trust. Okay, so great responsibility on me. That is why I always try to come up with new things and all that. Okay, now let's take a start. We've got academic reading, and the first question type is list of headings. Whenever we have list of headings, always remember, list of headings are basically extra headings as well, like trap headings, and then there are five. For example, if there are eight headings, out of eight headings, we are going to use six or sometimes five headings. Two headings are extra. And extra headings are made in such a way that you might think this heading can go with any paragraph, right? Now, whenever you're doing list of headings, first of all, you should read the title of the passage. Let's do it. Flying tortoises. Wow. Flying tortoises. Now we understand it's a tortoise that is going to fly in the air. So flying tortoises is the title. Is that clear? After that, we have subtitle as well. So let's read subtitle. Now, are you imagining tortoises flying in the air? Yeah. Your imagination should be strong, right? Then there'll be the impact on you. An airborne reintroduction program. Airborne means like through aeroplane or helicopter, they did something. Reintroduction program has helped conservationists take significant steps to protect the endangered Galapagos tortoise, right? So they are going to talk about endangered tortoise. Endangered means there are few of them left and they're trying to help them. So we understand they lifted the tortoises through aeroplane or whatever and then they dropped them there. So this passage is all about that conservation project. Conservation means to save them for future so that they don't die out, okay? And endangered species. Endangered species is the species of animal that is close to becoming an extinct. Like dinosaurs are extinct now, right? Okay, now we read the title, subtitle. After this, we are going to read the headings. And when we read the headings, once again, we are going to be imaginative. In IELTS listening and IELTS reading, your imagination will pay you, right? And by the way, your brain thinks in images. If I ask you, like, what did you eat yesterday? Like, what did you eat yesterday for lunch? Huh? Come on, chal chuta naan chane. All right, yeah. So, like, you know, first of all, your brain burger. Yeah. So, yeah, you started. Anyways, your brain is going to think about burger, right? All right, that's good. So your brain is going to create the image of burger, and then it's going to be there. If I ask you, when did you eat burger last time? So there'll be the images. Your brain thinks in images, and your brain restores information in images also. If I ask you about your last shopping experience, your brain will give you images, right? So then you just think about that. So if whatever you read, you create images, your memory is going to be very strong. And that strong memory is what we call retention. In IELTS reading, you need a little retention as well. Retention means what you read, you remember that for a short time, okay? So let's read the list of headings. Number one, importance of getting the timing right. Importance of getting the timing right. Underline timing. Now for timing, they can use days, weeks, months, years. They can use 15 minutes, 2 hours, 3 months, and all that. Getting the timing right means at the right time. Number two, young meets old. What are we going to talk about? Tortoises. So young meet old means young tortoises are going to meet old ones. Very simple. And now imagine small ones meeting the big ones, right? Heading number three, developments to the disadvantage of tortoise population. Developments to the disadvantage of tortoise's population. They will talk about some developments. These developments lead to disadvantages to tortoises. Right? Certain changes, like, you know, sometimes developments cause some destruction to something. So it's just going to be something like that. Heading number four, planning a bigger idea. For that, they say they all sat down and they made a plan or anything like that. Planning a bigger idea. And again, everything is for tortoises. Planning a bigger idea for tortoises, right? Yeah, exactly. Next is tortoises populate the island. Now, island and population, they will talk about population of tortoises at an island or on any island, the population of tortoises. They'll talk about that. Okay, I'm reading and explaining. That's why it's taking time, and you will do it quickly. Like that, okay? Yeah. But don't produce any noise in IELTS reading and listening. You can't even whisper. You're not allowed to whisper, for reading especially. If you whisper, they will come and say, be quiet, okay? Next is carrying out a carefully prepared operation. Carrying out operation means acting upon that operation. They will talk now. Operation doesn't mean very bazooka operation. Operation means the whole thing, activity. And when they talk about it, how to carry out that operation. I mean, when they acted upon that operation. Is that clear?
Yes.
Yeah, to everyone?
Security.
Huh? It can be security operation, it can be conservatory operation, it can be any other operation like that, okay? Alright, let's go on. Looking for a home for the island's tortoises. Looking for a home means a place to live for the island tortoises. So a paragraph for that. Heading number 8, start. And in the headings, never read article. Article is like the start of the and all that. Just read start of conservation project. Start of conservation project. And by the way, these type of things are found usually in paragraph ABC. Why? Because they said start of conservation project. So they will start with that and then they'll go on. Now we have read all the headings just here. Okay. Now the second thing is paragraph. Now listen carefully. In the paragraph, there is one sentence. I'm using the word one sentence. So in the paragraph, there is one sentence that is called topic sentence. So you will find that topic sentence, and once you find the topic sentence, the game is over. No problem. Because in list of headings, one sentence from the paragraph will match with the heading. And that's it. Now, how to locate that sentence? What is the right location of that sentence? It depends. Sometimes you will find that sentence in the first sentence. because some paragraphs, they start with the main idea. We call it main idea, or you can call it topic sentence. So what is going to happen in the first sentence, you will get that main idea. If it isn't there, you read and you see now they are talking about general things. They started with general idea. Then you will find topic sentence somewhere in the middle of the paragraph. And if it isn't there, then it's going to be at the end. But remember, headings should be at the back of your head. Now you've read all these headings, they should be there, and then you can find. Now, please come back. Paragraph A. Okay, for list of headings, there is the reading technique. We call it skimming. By the way, for IELTS reading, you need three type of readings or three techniques. The first one is skimming. Skimming is to read quickly so that you could understand the main idea. That is what we call skimming. And when you skim, you read something, you drop something, you again read something, you drop something, and all that. That is called skimming. I can give you a good example of skimming, like you're reading the newspaper in the morning. Like today I went for a car wash and there was the newspaper. In 2-3 minutes, I got all the things. So I was actually skimming through the newspaper, right? That is what we call skimming. Second is what we call scanning. Now, scanning is not reading. Always remember, when you scan, you do not read. What is scanning? For example, we are on this title page of the passage. Please come to that. Scan the number 1989. Good. Exactly. Very good. Now, before reaching 1989, did you read everything? Not at all. When you are scanning, you are only searching. You're searching for a word, you're searching for synonyms, you're searching for idea or anything like that. Okay, so just you got to keep that in mind. So after scanning and skimming, once you find the proper place where the answer is, now I tell you, many of will be having trouble with time management in IELTS reading. Why? Because you read the wrong part of the passage. After 1.5 minutes, you realize that I have come to the wrong place. Okay, and then you start coming back to another part of the passage. By doing this, your mind starts boggling, right? And then you don't know what to do. So if you're going on properly, if you reach the right part of the passage, let me tell you, 40 questions, that means there are 40 points in the passage or 40 sentences in the passage where you can find the answers. Now, how to reach those proper places? For that, you need skimming and scanning. And I'll tell you how to do that. So now, let's take a start. Paragraph A, please. Forests of spiny Kaktikova, and the words which are unusual, biological word, names of animals, names of places. The way you read, that's okay. And even don't try to read. Right, proper nouns, names of places, biological names, scientific words, and all that, right? And it is not necessary that you know the meaning of those words as well. It is not necessary. Okay, let's start from here. Forests of spiny cacti cover much of the uneven lava plains and all that. Please come to next sentence. With its 5 distinct volcanoes, the island resembles a lunar landscape, okay? Only the thick vegetation at the skirt of the often cloud-covered peak of this and that. All right, come to next sentence. This inhospitable environment now is coming to the point. Please focus. Sentence number 5. Please, everyone focus. This inhospitable, because before that he was doing all blah, blah, blah. That was just, you know, the background. Now he says, this inhospitable environment. This environment means the environment he mentioned is home to the giant Galapagos tortoises. Sometime after the Galapagos birth around 5 million years ago, the island were colonized by one or more tortoises from mainland South America. Now, they are talking about island, they are talking about population of these tortoises. This is the main idea of this paragraph. Please go back, read the headings, and then see if there is anything that matches with that. Now, let's see. Heading number 5. Tortoises populate the island. Is this clear? Now you can see, yes, in this paragraph, they have told us about tortoises' population and how they populate. I'm reading this sentence again. Please follow me. Fifth sentence, paragraph A. The inhospitable environment is home to the giant Galapagos tortoise. Sometime after the Galapagos birth, around 5 million years ago, the island were colonized. Exactly, colonized by one or more tortoises from mainland South America. Now, this time we found the main idea in the middle of the paragraph. So, 3 points are important. The first line, sometimes list of heading is so simple, first sentence will clearly tell you. Sometimes middle sentence, sometimes the last one. So mentally, I mean, listen, when they are explaining something and you realize that it's just the explanation or it's just the background info, then you can skip that sentence. And whenever you skip the sentence, start right after the full stop. Right? Because when you are skimming, in skimming, you are skipping also. Skipping means you read 2-3 words of a sentence, you realize they're just talking about the same thing. And then when we reach here, this inhospitable environment is home to the giant this and that, then we realize there is something main coming. So for question number 1, paragraph A, heading number 5 is the right answer. Now, few important things. The first thing is, whenever you are writing heading number, for list of headings, you will use Roman number. Roman number 5 is V. So you will use Roman number, the first thing. Second, when you have used one heading appropriately, you will cross that heading from list of headings. Why? Because one heading will be used once only. Okay? So now heading number 5, we cross it. Only cross the number. Number 5, just cross it. Not here, not here. Not with list of headings. With list of headings, one heading will go with one paragraph. Not more than that. Never. Never. Okay? Alright. Now we've got paragraph B and we go on with that. Please come to that. Paragraph B.
Next paragraph is within the next heading.
Yeah. Why not? नहीं हम थोड़ा सा वेट करेंगे पानी पियेंगे बर्गर खाएंगे Yeah. We'll go to the next paragraph. Immediately. Okay, now let's see paragraph B. Let's see where's the main idea. We're going to hunt for main idea. Before human arrival, the archipelago tortoises numbered in the hundreds of thousands. From the 17th century onward, pirates took a few on board for food. Tortoises are very delicious with tomato ketchup. Okay, so just joking. Now, pirates took a few on board for food. Now, if someone is going to eat the tortoise, it is going to be against tortoise community or population. Right? Let's go on. Sabar, bhai, sabar. Let's read on. The first thing. But the arrival of whaling ships in the 1790s saw this exploitation grow exponentially. This exploitation of tortoises grew. Actually, it grew exponentially. Relatively immobile and capable of surviving for months without food or water, the tortoises were taken on board these ships to act as food supplies. Now, they used tortoises and they act as food supplies during long ocean passage. And sometimes their bodies were processed into high-grade oil. Now, when they use tortoises for eating purpose, their body for oil purpose, baal lambe karne wala tel, kachwe da tel, something like that, okay? So now, just think about all these things, right? And now, they're explaining further. Now, let's go back to the headings and we see which heading is there. All these things are going against tortoises. Exactly. Heading number 3, developments. Now, these are the developments. Now, development is not always positive. It can be negative development as well. Developments to the disadvantage of tortoise population. And what were the developments? Pirates were taking them. Then again, the big ships, they were taking them. Then they were extracting oil from them. So, these developments were going towards the disadvantage. So, heading number 3 for paragraph B. Now, please cross 3 as well. So far, so good. And you got to repeat this test. When you go back home, you got to repeat it all. methods are same whether you are getting this list of headings in academic, general training, anywhere, method is same. Okay, now we go on to paragraph C. And one more thing, this is just a sort of tip. If you find a paragraph that is shorter, you can start from there. For example, paragraph C is short, paragraph D is short, paragraph G is short. Start from there and come towards the bigger paragraphs later. Right? This is another tip if you like. Otherwise, it's all fine. Okay, paragraph C. Today. Now, today means present. Today. Only 11 of the original subspecies survive, and these several are highly endangered. 11 species and they are highly endangered. And you know endangered. Endangered does not mean very dangerous. Okay, endangered means they are going to die out. Die out means khatam hone wale, napaid hone wale, like that. In 1989, work began on a tortoise breeding center just outside the town of Puerto, and all that dedicated to protecting the island's tortoises population. Now, just focus, 1980, work began on a tortoise breeding center just outside. Work began. Something started. Let's go back. Heading number? Burger Khan ka kya fayda hua jab aapko answer nahi mil rahe? Mil gaya? Heading number? Now what is that? The start of the conservation project. Now let's come back. For start, they use the word in 1989, work began. Work means conservation project and all that. And began means it started. Is that clear? So for paragraph C, heading number 8. And we will cross 8 also. Just cross the number 8. Why? Because when you read the heading second time, third time, now you are left with fewer headings. Otherwise, you will read all the headings. You will put one heading there. Later on, you say, oh, hi, I have used it already. So that's why you should cross the heading that you have already used. Okay, let's go on. Paragraph D. The problem was also a pressing one. Pressing problem means, pressing issue means important issue. Pressing problem means important problem. The problem was also a pressing one. Captive bred tortoises can't be reintroduced into the wild until they are at least 5 years old. Right? Now they're talking about some problem. Then they say, and weigh at least 4.5 kilograms, at which point their size and weight and their hardened shells are sufficient to protect them from predators. But if people wait too long, main idea is in the last sentence, focus. If people wait too long after that point, the tortoises eventually become too large to transport. If they wait after that, too large to transport. Now, this sentence contains the main idea. But if people wait too long after that means after that age. What is the age? 5 years. Exactly. Then they become very, very big and they cannot transport them. So, which heading? Samajari? Four is planning a bigger idea. Bhai, tortoise big hoga, idea big nahi hoga. Yeah. One is importance of getting the timing right. Now, why timing right? Actually, they mentioned here, first of all, they mentioned the age. And then they said, but if people wait too long after that point, the tortoises eventually become too large to transport. So, too long after that is actually that point. Okay, so for question number 4, paragraph D, heading number 1. And on your answer sheet, you will write these headings in Roman number. Clear? Okay, now we are going to go on to paragraph E. For years, repatriation efforts were carried out in a small numbers with the tortoises. Now this is small numbers with the tortoises carried on the backs of men. Imagine men were carrying the big tortoises and they were taking them back to their homeland. Over week of long treacherous hikes along narrow trails. So on the mountains, Imagine they were taking a sort of tortoise to there. But in November 2010, the environmentalist and Galapagos National Park liaison officer Godfrey Madeline, a visiting private motor yacht captain, and a helicopter pilot gathered around a table. They gathered around a table in a small cafe in Puerto Ayón on the island of Santa Cruz to work out more ambitious reintroduction. The aim was to use a helicopter. Now imagine, first they were carrying one tortoise on the back of a person to take it back. Now they were using a helicopter. Heading number? Planning a bigger idea. Now tell me, where is planning? Heading number 4, where is planning? When they said, they sat down, exactly. They said visiting this and that around a table in a small cafe, right? When they, pilot gathered around a table in a small cafe, that is planning. And then to work more ambitious reintroduction, the aim was to use a helicopter to move 300 of the breeding center's tortoises. Now 300 at one point, one only, and now 300. So they were planning a bigger idea. How do we get to know bigger idea? Because 300 tortoises they were planning to carry through helicopter. Okay. Okay. So for question of this is paragraph E. Paragraph E, heading number 4 is the right answer. Let's go on. Next, we've got paragraph F. Okay. Now let's just take a look. This unprecedented effort was made possible by the owner of the 67-meter yacht White Cloud, who provided the Galapagos National Park with free use of their helicopter. Bluetooth off karne iska. Okay, they had a helicopter and the person offered helicopter. Let's see. And its experienced pilot. So just imagine one person offered his helicopter and pilot, as well as the logistical support to the yacht, and they're going on. Please come to the next sentence. 150 kilometers. Got it? Let's just go on. This weight together with that of the fuel pilot and four crew approached. Now please come to the next one. During a now you understand. I mean just skimming and getting the idea. Pilot, helicopter, support, total weight, including those tortoises. During a period of 3 days, a group of volunteers from the breeding center worked around the clock to prepare the young tortoises for transport. Meanwhile, park wardens dropped off ahead of time in remote locations, cleared landing sites within the thick burst and all that. Now, just keep all these things in mind and go back and see what is it that they are talking about. Seven is looking for a home for the island. Now, this is not the scope of the whole paragraph. So, excellent. Heading number 6, carrying out a carefully prepared operation. Now let's see. Carrying out a carefully prepared operation. Let's go back. See, they are preparing the tortoises to fly, right? And then they're talking about helicopter, total weight and all that. So actually, they are carrying out this carefully prepared. How carefully prepared? They measured the weight and size and all that. So it's actually heading number 6, carrying out a carefully prepared operation. Is that clear? Yeah, you can just match it. You can work on it at home. And this is the heading. Now, where is the clue and all that? Okay, now we are left with paragraph G. And by the way, a list of headings will take more time. After that, whatever you done, have you noticed one thing? We've been through all the passage now. So the next questions which you are going to do, they will take less time. Another technique is whenever you do list of headings, before you start list of headings, read other questions also. Why? Because as you're doing list of headings, you reach paragraph C and you realize there is the answer of another question. You can always solve that as well. So this is how you can kill two birds with one stone. Anyways, paragraph G. Now, what are the headings which are left? Heading number 2, young meets old. And heading number 7, looking for a home for the island tortoises. So, upon their release, the juvenile tortoises quickly spread out over their ancestral territory, investigating their new surrounding and feeding on the vegetation. Eventually, one tiny tortoise came across a fully grown giant. See that? Now see this sentence, one tiny tortoise. One tiny means young, okay? And fully grown giant means old. So for paragraph G, question number 7, the right answer is heading number 2. Now which heading was trap? 7. Yeah, it didn't go anywhere. Looking for a home for the islands. Alright. Now listen, once again to summarize, for list of headings, read the title of the passage. If there is any subtitle, read that. Switch on your imagination. Imagine everything. And then put, when you read the headings, put these headings in your imagination. Like you can just fix these headings there as you are thinking. And when you read the paragraph, you got to find the clue word, or you got to see what is the direction of the paragraph. And try to start with the paragraph which is shorter one. There you can do it quickly, and then you can move on to other ones, right? Okay, thank you.